Hi, I'm Stimpy, sysop of the Kühlbox and writer of the Phidion install script. Phidion installs everything you need for running a FidoNet node or point on top of Debian or Raspbian. If you don't know what this is, you probably want to watch another video, since I won't explain the basics of FidoNet, but only how to use one very specialized script. Oh, in case you didn't hear it already, I'm not a native speaker, so please excuse wrong pronunciations or overall strange language. I'll try my very best. For Raspbian, there's an image you can use for easy setup. It's a vanilla Raspbian image which downloads and runs the Phidion installer the first time you log in as user Pi. If you don't trust shady images from the interwebs, which you shouldn't, or you are on an existing Debian or Raspbian installation you don't want to redo, this guide is for you. While Phidion should always work for stable and old stable of Debian and Raspbian, which is Stretch and Buster at the time of making this video, the system used for this example is a fresh install of Debian Buster 64 bits from the netinstall ISO. On my system, sudo was missing, so I had to install it and add my normal user to the sudo group first. On your system, this might already be done, partially or completely. If you don't know, just do it. It doesn't hurt when it's done twice. Log in as root, then type apt install sudo. This is followed by a lot of information about the installation. When it's done, add your standard user to the group sudo. In my case, that user is called Stimpy, so I typed add user Stimpy sudo. You'll have to replace Stimpy with your standard username. That's the non-root user you're using for your everyday tasks you will be using for installing Phidion. When that's done too, log out by pressing Ctrl and D or typing exit. Next, log in with your standard user. Then download the Phidion installer by typing wget https /fido.de/fidosetup.sh. After downloading, run it using sudo by typing sudo bash fidosetup.sh. This will first ask for your password, then automatically install all the packages needed. After a few seconds or a minute, the interactive part of the installation process will begin. This will ask you a few questions to automatically generate all the configuration files needed for BinkD, Husky, and GoldAd. The link name is a generic name only used internally. This can be FidoNet, for example. The domain is used to group different networks and set ACLs for your up and down links. This is standardized, and you should enter what your uplink told you. For FidoNet, it's FidoNet in all lowercase. Your name is your name. Some FDN networks, like FidoNet, require real names, so if you're planning on using any of these, you should enter your real name here. Your AKA was given to you by your uplink. If you're a point, it's the same AKA as your uplinks, but with a dot and a number added to the end. For this example, I'm point number 10 of myself, so my AKA is 2:240/5853.10. The system name is free choice again. It's presented to every caller and everyone called, for every BinkP connection, that is. The geographical location doesn't need to be 100% accurate, but it should give a strong hint to where in the world you are. Next, you'll need to enter a fully qualified domain name for your Phidion host. This can be imaginary if you're not publicly reachable, but it has to be a FQDN. Next, you'll need to enter the host name or IP of your uplink. For me, that's my BBS, so I've entered kühlbox.wtf. For you, this may vary, except I'm your uplink. Next, you can enter a port for BinkP if it's not the default one, which is 24554. If it is, you can just leave it blank. Next, you'll have to enter your uplink's AKA. If you're a point, this can, but doesn't have to be the same as yours, but without the last part after the point. So for me, this is 2:240/5853. Finally, you're asked for many passwords. These will be given to you by your uplink again. Since FidoNet is all about retro tech, there are still many systems not capable of lowercase letters, for example. So be careful what to choose. FidoNet is everything but secure anyway. I normally use passwords consisting of 8 random uppercase letters and numbers. It's a good idea not to use the same password for sessions and the rest, but this strongly depends on what your uplink decides, so just go with it. If all passwords are the same, you can skip all but the first password prompt. That's it. Phidion will now automatically generate all the configuration files needed based on the questions you just answered. In the end, you're asked to press Enter for setting a password for your newly created username Fido. Do it or follow the instructions given if you don't. After that, you're done. You can log out again by pressing Ctrl and D or typing Exit. Now just a few first steps around. Log in as user Fido using the password you just set. Then start the mail editor by typing goldedit. Enter the netmail area using your cursor keys and enter, then start a new netmail by pressing insert. Enter areafix in all capital letters as the receiver's name and your uplink's aka for destination. As subject, enter the areafix password you got from your uplink. For the message body, you can do %help and %list for now. This will send you help and a list of all available echoes. Save the message by pressing Alt-S, then exit goldedit by pressing Escape until you're out. Now you could just wait. Everything will happen automatically. Your mail is exported as soon as you leave goldedit, and it's being sent as soon as it's exported. But this will still take up to 10 minutes and more, since you'll have to wait for the answer and the default interval for automatic polling is set to 10 minutes. If you don't want to wait that long, you can start all the processes needed manually via command line. First enter netscan.sh. This will scan your netmail area for new mails and export them for transmission to your uplink. Then enter poll.sh. This will connect to your uplink and send and receive any new mails. Now wait a few seconds so your uplink system can unpack, toss and process your message, then run poll.sh again. Finally, run toss.sh to import all newly received mails into your message base. Then run goldedit again and look into your netmail area. There you should find help and a list of available echoes. If you don't, quit goldedit, wait a bit longer, rerun poll.sh and toss.sh, then look again. If you don't have any answer after about an hour, contact your uplink using some other channel. Next, you could subscribe to some echoes by writing a mail to areafix again. Use all the same header data, but something like plus points for the body. The standard syntax is plus echo name to subscribe and minus echo name to unsubscribe. Wildcards can work depending on your uplink, but best you first read the help message you just received. That's it. If you have any more questions or problems, just visit me at kühlbox.wtf or drop me a mail at stimpy@kühlbox.wtf. I'm happy to help whenever I can, and I guess your uplink is too. So have a nice day and a lot of fun using FidoNet.